Welcome to the motherland, where her children love playing football. And the game, well, it really is like a religion. We're in Abidjan, Ivory Coast, where in one of the world's least developed countries is one of the world's elite football academies. Their style of play has influenced the national team's style, and they're responsible for a lot of the big names to come from these shores. Copa Fam, this is ASEC Mimosa.
Je pense que la ASEC Mimosa c'est la locomotive du football ivoirien.
Everybody wanted to create an academy in Africa.
Their dream is going to Europe.
C'est ma vie ça, le club l'ASEC. C'est ma vie.
On January 1st, 1948, a group of football fanatic businessmen from Western Africa and France formed Amicale Sportive des Employés de Commerce, which roughly translates to Sporting Association of Business Employees. But it became known to the world because of one thing, ASEC Mimosa's football club.
ASEC Mimosa became a professional club and a popular club from 89. Before, it was not very well organized. Every year, the chairman was changed because the fans were not happy.
He had a new conception of club. He tried first to organize the club.
In the last 27 years, it was the same president, the same chairman. And in 26 years, we're 17-time champion of Côte d'Ivoire.
C'est un club professionnel. C'est un club qui amène le joueur au haut niveau.
Sur les autres équipes, on est déjà à 100 ans d'avance sur eux.
Our opponent in Africa is Africa Sport, and their color is green and red. Their goal is blood on the pitch. The one is fighting, the other one is playing football. We are more playing football.
Our World Cup team in 2006 in Germany, even in 2010 in South Africa, the most of the players come from this academy.
Our job is to help the boy to grow and to become a good player and a good man. That's our job.
C'est le seul club qui décore ses supporters pour le travail bien mérité.
The real jewel of ASEC's setup is their academy called Académie Mimosive.com. It was founded in 1994 by their president Roger Ognier and former French international Jean-Marc Guillou, and formed a foundation that still thrives today.
A voulu le mettre en place en Afrique, connaissant le potentiel des joueurs sur le sol africain qui était inexploité.
So they started with boys. They were 11, 12 years old, and it was the first time in Africa that a club created an academy only with young boys and with a school, with everything. What we want is to make the young boys have fun and playing football. It was in 1994 arrived Yaya Touré, Kolo Touré, Gervinho, Salomon Kalou.
Que c'est impossible de dire tous les noms, on oublie.
Mais quand j'ai découvert, d'abord c'est Kolo, j'ai découvert. C'est un grand joueur. C'est là que je l'ai proposé à Jean-Marc Guillou, qui m'a dit qu'il a, il a un petit frère qui joue mieux que lui.
He came in here in the training center. He said, okay, take this boy, take this boy. Yaya, take Polo, take Aruna Dindan, take them for free, nothing. I give you the boys. I don't know what to do with them because there were no academies, nothing. And today, if you want a player, it's a fight. Because the club won the Champions League in 98, and then the season later you play the Super Cup. So they play against Esperance de Tunis, which is one of the best team in Africa from Tunisia. But the club decided to change all the team after the season 98. And in 99, the academy played for the first team. The African Confederation said, no, it's not serious, you can't play the final of the Super Cup with those boys. They were 17, they were very small guys, and they won 3-1.
Mon meilleur souvenir, c'est quand on a pris la Coupe d'Afrique. Parce qu'ici, ils ont dit ici que la SEC ne prendra jamais de coupe.
Donc j'étais l'homme le plus heureux. Parce que partout, on disait, ah, président Ropero, tes enfants ont fait l'honneur à la Côte d'Ivoire. C'est ça qui a été le plus... C'est là que j'étais le plus content de ma vie.
Before being a football player, you are a boy. And first you need to go to school. Sometimes you look at the passport of the boys at 13, 14 and it's written profession as a football player.
Donc les enfants, dès qu'ils arrivent, on leur demande de vraiment être humble, d'avoir un bon comportement. Je sais que seul le talent ne peut pas faire un grand joueur. Il y a seulement le comportement qui peut amener un joueur à aller plus loin possible et durer dans le football.
Il faut aider le joueur à se développer, mais aussi le jeune homme et progressivement l'homme dans son développement.
So in the academy, they train one or twice a day. So it's around between 1 and 3 hours per day on the pitch. And certainly 5 or 6 hours at school.
De l'argent en famille, on n'aurait pas accès aux meilleurs jeunes.
Où on peut passer et puis avoir le professionnalisme et être dans de meilleures conditions aussi. Parce que passer ici, c'est déjà s'apprêter au professionnalisme. C'est la raison pour laquelle nous passons par la SEC, pour pouvoir aller le plus loin possible.
Donc vous avez pu le voir sur les chambres, il y a les noms de ces anciens joueurs, pour que ça inspire un petit peu les jeunes actuellement en formation.
Is there pressure for you guys to perform better, knowing the fact that so many great players have come from this place?
De voir ces grandes stars là, du monde entier évoluer ici, et ça nous permet nous aussi de pouvoir suivre leurs traces, de pouvoir faire ce qu'ils ont fait et pouvoir aller porter aussi ce nom du club là très haut. C'est pour nous c'est une grande joie. C'est pas une pression.
Donc on est obligé d'essayer d'optimiser un petit peu l'héritage qu'on a eu. Et c'est ce qu'on essaye de faire tous les jours, en essayant d'apporter la meilleure formation possible à nos jeunes footballeurs pour leur donner la même chance qu'ont eu leurs prédécesseurs d'avoir une carrière au plus haut niveau.
Former coach of Ivory Coast Sven Goran Eriksson once said, ASEC Academy is probably the world's most successful football academy. And he's not wrong either. ASEC hold the world record of an unbeaten team in a league season with 108 games without a loss between 1989 and 1994, which earned them 4 league titles and 3 cups.
Même il y a eu un match où on a fait sortir en nocturne. Ils ont fait sortir 2 joueurs de la SEC contre une équipe. On était mené 2-0. On allait dans les vestiaires. Quand on est revenu des vestiaires, à 8 là, on a battu l'équipe 4-2. Vraiment, on était heureux. Et quand c'est comme ça là, je dors bien.
With the likes of Drogba and the Touré, football has always had the capacity to unite and excite the nation. But interest in domestic football has suffered as the lure of European teams has consumed the clubs. Quick money from transfer fees trumps retaining players, improving the facility and the long-term gains.
20 years ago, when ASEC played in Asia, you can have 30,000 or 40,000 fans in the stadium.
When there's a game, ASEC Mimosa against Africa Sport, on Sunday at 3 o'clock, the guy say, okay, I can see Chelsea against Manchester United, but we're in competition with all games all over the world.
The first problem in Africa is how to keep the best footballer in the country. And if you want to keep them, you must have money.
The best player in ASEC is paid around $1,000 per month. So the problem is that everywhere in the world, they can get more. And 1,000 Ivorian players are playing outside, are not playing in Ivory Coast. So the best players, the top players, they are not playing here. And we transferred them to European clubs. So it's also our fault. You know, when a player wants to leave, it's very difficult to keep.
This European dream also threatens ASEC in less obvious ways. The academy used to have a monopoly over Abidjan's young players, but as agents look to capitalize on the desire of European teams for African players, over 300 rival academies have formed in this city alone. The name and reputation of ASEC puts it head and shoulders above the others, but competition is fierce.
Because there are a lot of talented players in Ivory Coast or in Africa, but what Africans need is not players, because they are. But it's organization.
They have a ground, maybe 20 or 30 kids and 2 or 3 balls, and they say it is academy. I say no, it is not academy.
Ils font payer les parents. Ils font payer les parents. C'est pas bon. Moi, je suis contre ça.
A lot of people created academy only academies, The business model is what? Okay, I train the boy. When he's 18, I transfer him. But in Aztec Mimosa, we have another philosophy. We want to be a club. So with an academy, with the first team. In the past, all the boys wanted to come here. But now it's quite difficult because first, what they want is to leave Ivory Coast. The goal is to leave Ivory Coast. So playing football, it could be great.
Oh, gloire à toi, Aztec Mimosa. Tout le peuple te soutient pour la victoire. Oh, gloire à toi, équipe jaune et noire. Vive l'Aztec Mimosa.
I'm very proud to work here because we are developing a unique project. And we have time. I hope football will develop in the next year, the economy will develop, and I'm very confident with our project.
Mais c'est le plus bel exemple de professionnalisme et d'organisation en Côte d'Ivoire.
Normalement, la Côte d'Ivoire doit reconnaître le mérite de M. Roger Wignan. Mais on doit reconnaître jusqu'à présent sa mérite. C'est lui qui a apporté beaucoup au football ivoirien.
So maybe to win, we won Barcelona under 17, maybe in the future is to win against Barcelona with the top team. But well, I know where we are.
Many stories about Africa are notoriously negative. Disease, war, hunger, some of these are just a fact of life. But across Africa, on dusty pitches like this one, there are uplifting stories. One of them is Aztec Mimosas. The domestic league might be in decline, but this hasn't stopped Aztec from following their principles. The academy is not just about football though, it's about discipline, it's about education, and giving these kids a better chance. Who knows, they may have the next Yaya or Javinho on their books as well. That's it from Africa. Make sure to subscribe to Copper 90, like this video, and leave a comment of where you want the next African story to come from.